Hey guys, what's up? And welcome everybody to the video. And if you guys have not heard the news, then you're going to be absolutely stunned by what we're about to talk about. There's something weird going on with PUBG, where it seems like everything that we speak about in videos is like coming true. So for example, patch 30 that just came out the other day with the Desert Eagle and the exploding gas cans and all that sort of stuff seems to be heavily influenced by the things that we talk about on this channel. And not only that, but the story mode ideas that we've had in the past are also coming true. So the news that we have to talk about in today's video is going to be absolutely insane. If you guys are excited for this stuff, then make sure you do drop a like on the video. I'd appreciate that very, very much. And of course, subscribe if you are brand new around here so you can stay up to date with everything that's happening with PUBG, as this game is on an absolute roll with content. And this game is seriously making some big moves, so you're going to want to make sure you sticking around here. But with that stuff being said, so what's the big idea here? What is happening with PUBG recently? Now, it's important that I give you guys a little bit of background context as to what the development has been looking like at PUBG just basically this past year or so, and all the changes that it's made and gone through. Now, you guys know Brendan Green, who is basically the main brain behind this game, has moved over to PUBG Special Projects. He's no longer at the main PUBG Corp that is in charge of development of this game recently, but he's on a Special Projects team, in which whatever that entails, we aren't entirely sure all the details, but we know that he's over there. And so while Brendan Green may not be the actual driving force behind the, current updates of PUBG and what it's going to be doing in the future, he is still very much fundamentally involved with the IP of PUBG. And so he's doing a lot of work behind the scenes that just either of us have no idea about. So it's also important to note that since Brendan Green is no longer the flagship of the development of the BR version of this, then there's going to be another team that is basically in charge of that or taking this place. And so far, if you ask me, I think they've been doing a really good job. You know, the content updates for this game have been absolutely phenomenal, and a lot of people are jumping back into the game and enjoying it. So in my opinion, the leadership of the way that the direction of the Battle Royale, which is the most important component of the PUBG IP, the way that this is going, it doesn't worry me at all. I think everything's been absolutely great so far, and I'm looking forward to the future. But that being said, there's still a lot more going on that was behind the scenes that we are only just now seeing. And finally, one of the biggest projects to ever happen to this game was finally revealed this morning. I saw it just as soon as I woke up, but I rushed to come over here and make this video. Basically, Glen Schofield is now in charge of a brand new game studio called Striking Distance. Now, this game studio is a fully fledged development team, which is being led by Glen Schofield, of course, and this studio is now in charge of flagshipping a brand new video game, like a complete brand new game that is a narrative story, an original narrative in the PUBG universe. And I literally could not believe this news. Like, I thought I was dreaming as I was watching this video and reading this update. Because you might remember many months ago, Brendan Green was in an interview in which, you know, the interviewer was asking him if there was ever ideas for a PUBG campaign mode, or if that was ever going to be something that was to be in the future. And Brendan was pretty much like, no, like, they have no plans to make a campaign, and they just wanted to solely focus on the BR experience. But since Brendan Green is no longer flagshipping the BR, but he's still under the PUBG IP in a way, this looks like the best opportunity to make a story mode or to let that be a thing. Now, it's not entirely clear how much Brendan Green is going to be behind this project himself or how much of his input is going to be in this game, but what we do know is Glen Schofield is pretty much going to be the main manpower behind the development of this game. And Glen Schofield has worked on many great games in the past, such as Dead Space and Call of Duty. And I've met Glen back when he worked at Call of Duty, and it's so weird because that's where I originally knew Glen from. If you guys are not familiar with the history of my channel, you guys might know that I am a big Call of Duty Zombies fan, and back when that was the main thing on this channel, that's when I had met Glen Schofield, when he was spearheading things like Advanced Warfare and also Call of Duty World War II. Now, Glen Schofield didn't work on the Zombies mode itself, which is what I was primarily interested in, but when I met him at the studio for like capture events or something like that, then I could tell just by speaking to him that he is unbelievably passionate about video games. You can see this attitude reflected if you've played games like Dead Space again, or if you've played the Advanced Warfare campaign. Glen is the man behind this, so if you liked games like that in any way, then you should absolutely love this brand new campaign project, this story mode for PUBG, if you will, because Glen is really talented at making, you know, campaigns and narratives that really compel you or that draw you in. And the reason I'm telling you all this is because this means I have full faith in not only Glen, but also this Striking Distance studio. Now, you might ask yourself, okay, that's great, but what does that mean for the BR? How are these things going to relate? What I think is going on right here is the best possible scenario, because it's not like PUBG Corp itself is pulling the devs off of the Battle Royale team to develop the story mode, which, if you ask me, I think that would be an absolute disaster because I don't want to see the biggest like draw towards this game get less development time because it certainly needs it. A lot of the content that has been coming out recently, of course, requires a lot of devs, but it's been great. So I have no complaints there, and that's a good thing. So what's great is that they're outsourcing it to another studio that isn't going to take away from the BR at all, but only be additive to this narrative story. Now, I think it goes without saying that BR will always and forever be the core feature, or I guess the core game mode of PUBG. Like, without Battle Royale, this game wouldn't be what it is today. However, what Glen Schofield wants to do, he quotes and he's saying this: "The freedom to explore the PUBG universe has me excited about the possibilities, which we view as beyond Battle Royale." And the CEO of PUBG Corp has this to say about it: "That vision is taken to the next level as our development and service portfolio expands and diversifies with Glen Schofield and striking distance. We are thrilled to welcome Glen to the company. His unique blend of proven leadership and boundless creativity will help us create great synergy." So great, a brand new PUBG video game is coming. That's awesome. So what is this actually going to entail? Well, let's discuss some details. Now, we know already that PUBG has had its own lore built into the Battle Royale, and whether that was Brendan Green's idea, we don't know for sure. It might have just been something that was developed as a whole at the studio, but we know that basically the story of each map kind of goes like this. For Erangel, it's set on a fictional island in the Black Sea, essentially, which a Soviet military overtakes the island and in turn the population that lives there as well, subjects all of them to biological and chemical testing, and you can see this reflected in echoes of this in the mechanics of PUBG itself. And that lore has been even more expanded in the Erangel remaster, which is a really, really good hint at to the direction of this game and what we can expect in this story mode. Now, if you've not seen my videos on the secrets of Erangel remaster, then feel free to check out that video if you want a little bit more detail on what these actually are. But inside of this map, there are secret areas in which the story is more of the main focus of this. And in this particular house in the secret cellar that I'm going to show you, this seems to be the special hideout, or at least one of them, of the dictator who is number one in charge of this army that has taken over. This seems to be like a base of operations for this entire military. Now, there's a couple of these around the map, and they also have like a little bit of different things to show within each one. And not only is there a military faction that is like that has their own secret bunkers in this map, but if you go to different houses that, again, if you want to have the details on exactly which houses those are, go check out that video where I talk about them more in detail. But there are certain other houses that have another cellar that is similar to this one, although it's for the resistance or the rebellion. And what we're seeing play out in the Erangel remaster lore is the resistance and the fight between these two factions, this military, which is represented by the eyeball, and then the resistance, which is represented by the lion flag. And what we know by checking the resistance cellars is that there's a ton of clues about some new hidden Easter eggs and other secret areas that are going to be within Erangel remastered. And so if we were going to go into all the detail of this stuff, then this would be way too much to unpack in this video. But what I want to know from you guys is if there's any interest in me going over all of the story of all of the maps, then let me know, like a full detailed story of Erangel, Miramar, Sanok, and Vikendi, because I will if you guys are interested in that. If you guys are interested in seeing a video like that, then I guess just show me by dropping a like rating and I'll get the message. But anyways, it seems to me right now that this PUBG story mode is going to play off the lore that is already established in Erangel remastered. And so in the future, if we're going to be getting remastered maps, then it looks like we're going to be getting even more lore. Now, Miramar actually has a really interesting story, and I think that they're going to expand on that if they do remaster that map, and also in the story mode of campaign itself. So we know two things. First of all, there is a story mode coming to PUBG, and we also know that it is going to be based off the lore that, you know, PUBG has already established. But what we don't know for sure is they didn't mention exactly that this is a single player game. And the reason I bring that up is because Glen Schofield has talked about in the past how he wanted to develop a game that is basically like a story or a narrative based game, but that you can play with multiple people. Now, that is a little bit speculative, so don't take that as 100%. And it also is really hard to tell a really well crafted narrative if you're playing with other players as well, because it just, you know, it kind of works differently than if you're just playing by yourself. But either way, it seems like the story is going to be fully expanded in this brand new game, the single player mode, whatever it is. Now, a while ago, we talked about the idea for the campaign being that you play as one of the resistance fighters in this, and you basically, you know, go from compound to compound playing against this oppressive military and eventually escaping or freeing people, stuff like that. Now, of course, that was just our idea for a video, and it is something that if Glen Schofield is manning the story, then it's going to be way more complicated and better crafted than that. But what's so awesome to me is that we already have like little inklings, and we have an idea of what we're going to be getting in this brand new game if you're paying attention to PUBG. Like, if you're up to date on all the Erangel remastered stuff, then you're already going to be up to date or even ahead of most players on the story. And another thing I think is worth mentioning is this, right? Because this is a story mode, it's being developed by a brand new studio, they're going to have assets that are only available in the campaign mode. But what I suspect might happen is they have assets that would work really well in BR, and then PUBG Corp can use these and implement them into the Battle Battle Royale. Obviously, not everything, but it seems like the story mode is going to be a really good opportunity for PUBG Corp to use like new assets developed by this studio to implement into BR, the ones that fit, of course. And as far as development on this brand new game and when it's going to come out, they didn't mention either, but what I will say is they're comfortable enough to mention that this game is coming out and that this is being worked on, so you gotta imagine it's going to be probably relatively soon. Although, I'm actually in no rush for this game to come out, because what I would like PUBG to do first is maybe, you know, extrapolate on the lore a little bit that they already have going, especially when Aaron Gill Remastered hits live servers, and then if they plan to remaster more maps whenever they're going to do that. I feel like if these two things are happening simultaneously, that will be the best case scenario, because it'll get people who are interested in the story who have just played the BR wanting to play the campaign mode, and then people who just play the campaign mode for the first time ever and have not played the Battle Royale experience will probably be encouraged to do that as well and get a little bit more of a hands-on experience. I think this is an extremely great move PUBG is doing, and I cannot be more happy to announce that this is actually happening. And so I'm going to be doing a full playthrough of this story mode on this channel, so if you haven't already subscribed and you want to make sure you stick around and see that, please make sure you do, because as soon as this drops, you're going to be seeing a full playthrough of it on this channel. But let me know inside the comment section what you guys think about the PUBG story mode. If there's anything as far as like storyline you want to see, or gameplay wise, like what kind of creative things would you like to see happen in the gameplay? I'd love to see you guys throw around ideas down below in the comment section, and I'll try to respond to as many as I can and talk with you guys about it too, because I'm just excited as you all are. But I'm so happy to finally announce this, and guys, like, it's literally a reality. PUBG is getting a story mode for everybody, for all the myths that it was never going to happen. It's coming, and it's just like, it's mind-blowing news. But let me know you guys' thoughts down below in the comments, and make sure you go follow my Twitter for faster updates on this kind of thing. Link will be down below in the description, and also make sure you guys go subscribe over to my second channel, which is also linked down below in the description. Make sure you do both of those, and without further ado, I'll see you guys in the next stream or the next video. Take it easy, and peace out.